and Xingao from China. The first one in combination. Quadruple toe, double toe. Remarkable. He missed the second attempt, so he threw in another one. Amazing.
And Ilya Kulik skating a clean program for the evening, but starting here with the quad. Beautiful. Answering it right after that with a triple axel, triple toe combination. Never once faltering on any element in his program. Setting the bar for the rest of the men to rise to. Todd Eldridge, after landing the first triple axel earlier in the program, a miss, a waxel right off the edge, decided at the end of the program to throw in another one, could not even stand up, and that was his chance for the bronze medal, gone. He knew it.
Elvis Stoico, fine on the triple lutz. However, there was no quad. It appeared throughout that Elvis Stoico was on damage control, for we were to learn that he had a major injury. He had pulled an abductor muscle a month earlier at the Canadian Figure Skating Championship, and he was fighting through it. It was amazing that he even made it through. Then the man who would steal the stage. He would give flair and panache to the men's figure skating event, unmatched by anyone. It was 25-year-old Felipe Candelero, and he had the performance of his life.
Quite something to take the time in a long program between all these other triples to really portray and feel a character, something we have not seen yet tonight. It adds so much.
The triple axel is going to be so important to make this character live. Here, the triple loop. Great.
Beautiful. He's knocking these triples off. Two left to go. He has created such a mood in this building.
Now, the momentum will build here. Look at this footwork step as he portrays a fencing fight.
Oh, it's just great. It's the most innovative choreography we've seen tonight.
Stay on your seat, Roz. Wow.
Well, I am a fan. Taking a little time to rest before the triple axel. Yet never losing the character. He needs this triple axel right here at the end of the program.
Here it is. No, he flipped out of it.
Little turnout, but that's okay. He didn't go down. One more triple sow cow, and he's home free.
What a bang!
Yes.
Not finished off, but again, not a fall.
Well, this program is going to bring this audience to its feet. Taking the time to thank this Japanese audience. And all of us, we thank him. Fabulous. He just connected with everyone in that building. It was really special.
It was. And you guys, I looked over at you. You were sitting on the edge of your seats, just smiling away. Candelero really relaxed everybody, the audience and the judges, when you think about it. I have to do a 180, though, because I didn't think he could rise to the occasion and do what he did. It was outstanding. And really, it wasn't about the quad with him. It was about the performance. And if I were the owner of an ice show, I guarantee you I would want to hire him, because he's just got this great entertainment quality. And when he came down the ice in that fencing fight doing that footwork, that was so cool.
I loved it. And really, it's about having that Olympic moment, which Philippe did. Now, unfortunately, Todd Eldridge didn't. He let the pressure get to him. He dropped to fourth place. He really wanted that medal. But, you know, he's here today. He's watching Tara Lipinski practice. He's still soaking up that Olympic feeling. And, you know, we've been talking a lot about the actual Olympic competition, but these guys are going to go on now and have a life as a professional. And they've all been thinking about this for months and for years. And the one that's going to have to go back now to the drawing board is Todd Eldridge. He'll make a great professional competitor, but I don't know about much show skating for him, unfortunately.
Okay. Well, that's it for today for The Cutting Edge. We'll see you soon. Yesterday, the three of us sent Peggy Fleming our hopes for her recovery from recent surgery, and we understand she's doing just fine. Now, three more of her fans here in Nagano would like to add their best wishes.
Hey, Peggy, it's Nicole. Just want to say we love you very, very much, and we're praying for you, and we love you, and things will go well, and we're definitely thinking about you, and I'm here for Carlo, so you know how I feel, and we love you, and I love you. Bye.
Hi, Peggy, it's Tara. I wish you the best of luck and hope you're feeling well, and have fun watching us this week. Bye.
Hi, Peggy. How are you? I miss you so much. It's not the same without you. I mean, with the games, and, you know, it's not the same when I look up in the crowd and not see your face. I hope you're doing very well. I heard the operation was successful, and I hope you get better soon, and remember that I'm thinking about you, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.